Hi guys, my name's Mandee, also known as the Kitchen Wife, and welcome back to my channel. So if you're new here, you may not know this about me, but I'm a food blogger. I blog over at thekitchenwife.net, which is basically where I share all my favorite recipes. So obviously, cooking is a big passion in my life. But the other big passion in my life is seasonal living. And basically what that means is I try to live each day to the fullest, each season to the fullest, and find reasons to celebrate every day. Because let's face it, life is too short to look and wait for the big things in life, right? So one of the ways I do that during the Halloween season is I watch a Halloween movie every night from October 1st to October 31st. I have about 20 movies in my collection now, which isn't a bad collection, but my goal is to get one for every day of the month. I'm not going to share all of those with you today, but what I thought I would share with you today are my top 5 family-friendly Halloween movies. Now, here's a disclaimer. I am not one of those girls who is all about the blood and the gore and the violence. Like, I'm not about crazy, scary horror movies and things like that. My husband definitely is, but I am not. So most of my Halloween movies are pretty family friendly, but out of my collection, I feel like these are the ones that are relatively safe for just about anyone. I will say, and I'll talk about this with each film, that some of these are a little bit more appropriate for younger children or older children than others. But without further ado, let's get to the video. Okay, so the first movie on my list is definitely Disney's The Haunted Mansion. It has Eddie Murphy in it, and I think this movie is hysterical. It's kind of like your quintessential fun Disney Halloween movie. The synopsis is, from the studio that brought you Pirates of the Caribbean, here's the fright-filled comedy adventure loaded with hair-raising laughs and eye-popping special effects. Eddie Murphy stars as a real estate agent whose family comes face to face with 999 Grim Grinning Ghost. 999 Grim Grinning Ghost in the creepy old Gracie Manor. Now, with the help of supernatural psychic Madame Leota, Jennifer Tilly in Liar Liar, they must hilariously battle to break the mansion of its age-old curse and do it before the clock strikes 13. Clock strike 13. Anyway, it's a super cute movie. Some of the effects may be a little scary for younger children, but I mean, if you have children in your house, I'm gonna say 8, 9, 10 and up, this is a great choice. The second movie may date me a little bit. I remember watching this as a kid and absolutely loving it. I will say that I think it might be definitely, again, for 8, 9, 10 years old and up, simply because of the special effects. It's from Jim Henson Studios, and it's called The Witches. Okay, the synopsis reads, from Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs to The Wizard of Oz, many classic tales through the centuries wouldn't be half as exciting without the devious doings of a witch. Now add another to the venerable tradition of stories that deliver family fun with every which way. A collaboration combining the effects wizardry of the executive producer at Jim Henson and the imagination of Willy Wonka creator Ronald Dahl. Academy Award winner Angelica Houston won the Los Angeles and National Society of Film Critics Best Actress Award for her marvelous work as the Grand High Witch in this entertaining fable directed by Nicholas Roeg. Jason Fisher plays Luke, the 9-year-old who must foil the plans of a society of witches to turn the world's children into mice. It won't be easy. They've already transformed him into one, but some big bad witches may be no match for the resourcefulness of a single tiny rodent. Super cute movie. It was filmed in the 80s, so the effects aren't as great as, say, The Haunted Mansion, but it's a great storyline. I absolutely love this movie. I enjoy watching it every year. And if that movie didn't date me, this next one really it will. This seriously was one of my favorite movies growing up, and that's The Worst Witch. This movie, I think, was filmed in like 85 or something like that. It stars Tim Curry and Farazuka Balk. She was in The Water Boy. I'm not sure if that's how you pronounce her name, but this is based off a book series. It says, when pupils disappear into thin air or turn into pigs by mistake, everyone points the fingers at Mildred. The worst witch in the school. No matter how hard she tries to master potions and flying, something always goes wrong. But horrid Miss Hardbroom wants Mildred expelled. But this little witch with a big heart does not give up until the day that all her hopes come crashing down. After running away from school, it will take all her courage and powers to conquer her fears and find her way. Hold on to your brooms while you join Mildred in this magical adventure of good and evil. Now, I will say that this DVD is a little hard to get a hold of, and when you do find it, it is kind of pricey. It's not in print anymore, and it is a collector's item. However, Netflix just released their own series on this book called The Worst Witch, and I did watch it, and it is pretty cute. Not as good as this one, but definitely a good runner-up. So if you can't find this, then go check that one out on Netflix. Now, I think this next one is not going to be a stranger to anyone in the Halloween world, and that is Halloween Town. I love this movie. Love, love, love this movie. You probably have already seen it. I love that pretty much when you buy this movie on DVD, it comes with Halloween 1 and Halloween 2. I actually have all four. But the synopsis says, join Marnie and her grandmother, Aggie, as they stir up a cauldron full of comedy and adventure in two Disney classics, Halloween Town and Halloween Town 2, Calabar's Revenge. On her 13th birthday, Marnie learns she's a witch, discovers a secret portal, and is transported into Halloween Town, a magical place where ghosts and ghouls, witches and werewolves live apart from the human world. But she soon finds herself battling wicked warlocks, evil curses, and endless surprises. Halloween Town's double feature will charm pixies, trolls, and families everywhere every day of the year. I love this movie. It's super fun for all ages, and I definitely recommend you check it out for your family. And last but not least, on my top 5 family-friendly movies, if you haven't guessed what it is, then you probably don't live on planet Earth, in which case, like, hit me up, because I'd love to have a conversation. But anyway, and that is Hocus Pocus. I mean, you don't really need to say anything. You know how on TBS, I think it is, they have an all-day Christmas Story marathon on Christmas Day? I think they're doing the same thing for Hocus Pocus on Freeform on Halloween. It's a classic. It doesn't get any better than this at Halloween. I think it's appropriate for all ages. Maybe a little scary for the younger ones. Some of the makeup work and stuff. But conjure up a cauldron of laughs with Hocus Pocus, a fiendishly fun movie, now on Blu-ray for the first time ever, featuring all new digital rest. Okay, anyways, you guys don't care about that. Let's get to the thing. The real storyline. When 3 17th century Salem witches are accidentally summoned by modern day pranksters, the 300-year-old trio sets out to cast a spell on the town and reclaim their youth. But first, they must outwit 3 kids and a talking cat. Get ready for a night of zany fun in this bewitching comedy classic, now even better on Blu-ray. So, yeah, Hocus Pocus. It's not Halloween. I actually have an entire party based around this movie every year. I invite all of my girlfriends over. We light up the fire pit outside. I set up the outdoor screen and projector, and we watch this movie. We dress up as witches. We have a lot of themed food. It's a good time. So yeah, that is my top 5 family-friendly movies for this Halloween season. I'd love to hear what some of your movie picks are, because like I said, I'm always looking to add to my collection. And I'll have all of these movies linked down below, so that way you can find them fairly easily. I hope you guys are having a great Halloween, and until next time, see you later. Wait, don't go anywhere. I left too soon. If you like this video and you'd like to see more of this kind of thing, please be sure to hit that subscribe button down below and click that little bell so you know that every time I upload. And yeah, I'm so glad and so thankful that you guys choose to watch every week, and I'll see you next time. Now you can go. Bye, guys.